Well, hello there. My name is Casual, and today I'm going to be talking about how you can take different game franchises and different game genres and place them into a different game and use this different plans, like results and different ways you can do stuff. Anyway, here we're going to be talking about how you can input MMORPG games like World of Warcraft, DC Universe, and stuff like that. They bring in a different output on the FPS franchise, as they're not first person, they're a third person most of the time, and they're like magic games and trolls and stuff. Some people may mock people that play that game, but playing a game like that does take some brains, and you can't be a complete child to play a game like that. I admit there are some children that play that game, and they just mainly get lucky, but there are some young people that are smart and play the game. Some people mainly think that people that play World of Warcraft and Dungeons and Dragons and stuff like that are all fat, overweight people. But people that play Minecraft, that's an online, like, that can be classed as an RPG, that is a role-playing game, because there are role-playing servers. And people that play that are fat, they just like to enjoy the sort of role-playing sort of satire of having fun, but, like, pretending they're something that they're not, and it's everybody likes to do it. Either if you're in the bedroom or you're on your keyboard, you like to do a bit of roleplay if you catch my drift. Anyway, I'm going to tell you how you can take World of Warcraft and place it into Call of Duty. Some of people go, oh, that's a stupid idea. But actually, it's quite a clever idea how I thought this out. In World of Warcraft, there is three main roles. And in many RPG roleplaying games, there are three roles. There is the DPS. DPS is a person that does damage, and most damage, so they're probably a high anticipated target. They're the people that go around killing people and killing monsters, and they're the ones that will be doing the most damage to the item, monster, or whatever you're killing. Then you have the tank. The tank is the person that holds monsters' damage to them. They aggro, which is aggravating the monsters, so the monsters focus on them and do most damage to them. So they can sit there and just tank it and do all that. And then you have the healers. The healers heal the tank and heal the DPS, so the healers and tanks, so the DPS and the tank do not die, and the healers can just keep there and doing that. And in World of Warcraft, it's the exact, that's basically what raids, instances, dungeons and stuff like that. People say, so how can you fit this into Call of Duty, Callum? Well, Call of Duty in Team Defender, you have the same three roles, basically. You have the tank. The tank is the person that holds the flag and holds off the most attack, and the person that has to take the most damage from the enemy units. Like, so, for instance, the team I'm playing against now, they're the monsters. And I'm a support class, so I'm a healer. Anyway, let's keep up. The tank is the person that holds the flag. Their goal is to take the most damage and try and hold the flag down the longest and just keep staying alive the longest whilst holding the flag. The people that got the people that are holding the flag are support, so they are healers. And basically, their job is just to protect the person holding the flag in... If they get down, or if they're injured, you can run in and try and defend them. So, you're healing them, in a way. It's basically the same idea. And then you say, hey, how can you say DPS then? Well, DPS is, some people don't like to be a support class, or don't like to hold the flag. Some people that just like to run around and take damage and kill people. So, they're basically just people that run in, take damage, and run and kill about, and just destroy people, blow the fuckers up, destroy them, whatever you want to call it. That's what they like to do. So run and gunners, they're basically the people that are DPS. They like to run around and kill people and just... Yeah. And some of you are going to say, well, that's not a very crucial role in this game time. Actually, it is. Due to the fact that we have a radius around where the enemy is spawning, we don't have any teammates that are too far out or too far in. As you can see, they did get into our spawn here, like where we are guarding the flag. They said guarding then. And where we are holding the flag down, the enemies are trying to come in, and we have the radius around the flag. And the DPSer, damage, the person that's running around, is basically killing people that are all around the map. Basically, they're running around the edge of the map, killing people that are in the center and killing them. So they all spawn together, and then they have to run as a group. And then the support class can defend the person and still pick off kills, though. It's a win-win situation. You scratch. If the DPS is killing people, they're helping you. And if you're killing them, the DPS has a chance of getting more people that are running around the map trying to get away from airstrikes and attack helicopters. Anyway, we've come to the end of the commentary. I'll probably continue this in the next commentary. I hope you enjoy, and please check out my channel, youtube.com/casualy. there you go. I hope you enjoyed, and goodbye, guys. Peace.